Where did that song come from?
Big painted Elvis. I used to really like this. We had one of those. My little brother actually had a big painted Elvis. And I wrote the song called Elvis, and it was really just a song about you can have everything, but I just want that cheesy little thing that I brought with me. That's all I brought in, and that's all I'm leaving with. I love that. I actually really like that song a lot. That song's a fun song. You had one?
You guys normally like the smaller venues to play at. It seems like most of your concerts are smaller.
We typically like the theater-sized rooms. You know, they're really conducive to what we do. I mean, we're really lucky. We get to do these kind of things, where we get to do kind of acoustic things. We get to play intimately. We get to play in some of the festival stages and larger stages like that. But the theater-sized rooms are really the ones that we've always been most comfortable with. Of course, if we could sell out amphitheaters, we probably would.
Well, yeah, because the arenas, it's so...
Arenas are so overplayed.
So overplayed. But honestly,
yeah, stadiums.
You know, we have played plenty of those, and I have more fun. I typically have more fun at big festival shows.
Ken, you have fun everywhere you go, pal. You're a fun guy.
I'm a fun guy.
What?
But those theater size, those 1,000 to 3,000 seat rooms are the most fun for me. Anybody else?
I think my nose just whistled. It happens all the time.
What's the farthest you played?
Japan.
Korea, yeah. We've gone a lot of places. Most of those places we don't remember because those were back in our crazy days. And so somebody pointed a flashlight and we were like, where are we? But I saw pictures and we were definitely in Japan.
No, that was Epcot.
It was weird. We did one night, we were in Mexico.
Dude, how long was I sleeping?
I was so hungover the next day. Remember that tour, man?
That was crazy. Every country, man. We actually do play Epcot yearly. We do their wine and food festival. We do multiple days down there. Just the one time where all our kids come and jump up on stage and praise King. We've been out there, but we're not going up there anytime soon. We'll be in New Orleans March 1st for the Rock Band. Those of you watching on live stream, something about these lights make it look like I'm losing my hair. In the room, it doesn't look that way, right? In the room, I look like Donald Trump.
Oh, is there a chance to watch another live stream show today?
There is an opportunity to watch a live stream show. You can actually watch sort of our whole day, and more importantly, you can watch the live show tonight from Janice. Janice Live TV, and you can go to janicelive.tv. Isn't that right? I think that's what it is. And you can actually see our entire show tonight from Janice Landing. Also, we have two openers, B-Liminal and Junior Doctor. Interesting facts about them. B-Liminal is managed by our very own bass player. What's his name again?
Barris.
Jet Barris. The drummer Mark Trojanowski manages Junior Doctor, and they are both very cool bands and very cool managers, I might add.
And we still have some general admission.
Yeah, there are some GA tickets still available for that. So yeah. There's no VIP stuff left, is there?
I don't think so. But if anybody was interested up until 3 today, I can give them our office number and you can get them there for like $4 less and no Ticketmaster charges or anything.
Okay, so for $4 off a GA ticket, the number to call would be?
250-0011.
Area code?
By 3:30 today.
Area code 813, but you need to call before 3:30 today and you can come on in. I love Janice. It's so much fun. Isn't that a great place to see a show?
And it's first Friday.
It's fun, yeah.
It's first Friday.
And it will clear up tonight.
So. Yes. It'll be in Brandon when we're rocking the stage and we'll have a thousand of our closest friends there.
It'll be great.
Yep.
It should be great. All right, so this is a song called Champagne High.